Several days ago, we posted the teardown video of the brand new Apple 70W GaN charger. You can click the upper right corner to check it. And as promised, we're gonna test the charging performance of this charger today. This is not the default charger for 15-inch MacBook Air. You have to buy it separately. As mentioned, the brand new 70W is slightly smaller than the previous 67W and is slightly larger than the Apple 30W. The round metal block can fix the AC plug. It can also used to be as a ground wire when you use a 3-prong plug. And the serial number inside the input socket can be matched with the adapter info of TurtleLab Power Z MF001. Since the size is smaller, the power density is about 0.6 watts cubic centimeter. The TurtleLab Power Z KM003C shows it supports PD 3.0 and DCB protocols. It also has 4 fixed speeds of 5V, 9V, 50V, 3A, and 20V, 3.4A. Then let's briefly review its charging compatibility. You can also click the upper right corner for more details. Since it cannot support PPS protocol, its compatibility depends on if the charging device supports PD 2.0. Apple devices are on top of the list. Without PPS, most Android phones cannot exceed 20W. But tablets, laptops, and game consoles have higher power and better compatibility with PD 2.0. And it can also charge your earphones and wearable devices. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 13-inch MacBook Air M2. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. The voltage is always around 20.4 volts, and the peak power is about 64 watts at 20 minutes. Then, it gradually drops to 54 watts and 38 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 12 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 20 minutes to be fully charged. We also plot it into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can charge the 13-inch MacBook Air M2 to 50% in 30 minutes and 80% in 1 hour. For the remaining 20%, it takes 1 hour and 20 minutes to be fully charged, which is even longer than the previous 80%. Except for the MacBook Air, we also use it to charge iPhone 14 Plus. The voltage is 9 volts at the beginning, and the peak power is about 26 watts. Then it'll gradually drop to 22 watts and 15 watts in turn. After 52 minutes, the voltage switches from 9 volts to 5 volts, and the charging power gradually drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 5 minutes to be fully charged. We also plot it into another curve. It can charge the iPhone 14 Plus to 50% in 26 minutes and 80% in 52 minutes. Like the MacBook Air, it takes 1 hour and 13 minutes to charge the remaining 20%, even longer than the previous 80%. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50 Hz is 0.079 watts and 0.039 watts at 110 volts, 60 Hz, which is about 0.692 and 0.341 kilowatts hour in 1 year respectively. So you do not need to worry about the waste of electricity. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 92.88% to 89.29% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 93.09% to 87.98% at 110 volts, 60 Hz. Except for 5 volts, 3A, the rest are above 90%. That's pretty rare and high. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 5 volts, 0A, the highest ripple is 42.4 millivolts peak-to-peak and 44 millivolts peak-to-peak. When the output is 20 volts, 0A, the lowest ripple is 16.8 millivolts peak-to-peak and 17.6 millivolts peak-to-peak. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. When the output is 20 volts, 3.4 amp, the highest ripple is 21.6 millivolts peak-to-peak. When the output is 5 volts, 3A, the lowest ripple is only 8 millivolts peak-to-peak and 10.4 millivolts peak-to-peak, respectively. Our previous teardown video shows it has 6 electrolytic capacitors for input filtering and 3 solid capacitors for output filtering inside. This is why the ripples are so low. Next, we're going to put this charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank and let it output 68 watts throughout the test. After an hour, we got the maximum temperature. Under 220 volts, 50 Hz, the front is 54.5 degrees Celsius and the back is 59.7 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts, 60 Hz. The maximum temperature on the front and back is 62.1 degrees Celsius and 58.1 degrees Celsius, respectively. According to the IEC 62368, the maximum temperature of plastic cannot exceed 77 degrees Celsius, so it complies with the standard. Well, that's all tests for this brand new 70W GaN charger from Apple. It's specifically designed for laptops and tablets. It's also much like the previous 67W charger, but is slightly smaller due to the internal GaN components. Meanwhile, our tests have revealed that the charging speed has not significantly improved compared to the previous generation. However, its standby power consumption and conversion efficiency are at top tier levels, and the ripple and temperature are also well controlled. Okay, that's all for today's video. Don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!